Not too long ago, I made a video on why Blackmagic Design and DaVinci Resolve will crush the competition in 2025. And it's because they listen. They listen to their user base, you and me. And when I was reading the list of everything that's new in the new DaVinci Resolve 20.1 update, I was like, holy crap, are they binge watching my videos and reading the comments? Because a lot of the things that they've improved now are things that I've complained about in my videos and you in the comments. So, you know, I absolutely love the new update. Here we go. And the first thing I noticed is how much they've improved the new keyframe and curves editor. I mean, it was already a great improvement when they introduced it, but a lot of people were not 100% satisfied, you know? So this update is great. First of all, they've improved the overall behavior of smoothening and easing curves and keyframes, but also, and this one I love, you can now also adjust the curves on the timeline. Before, it was only available up here in the curves editor. And for all of you looking for the ease in and out options down here, well, they're not down here. What you have to do is right click on a keyframe or speed point and the options will pop up. Also, when you trim a clip beyond the speed point or a keyframe, it will now still be visible. It will always be visible because before it just disappeared and that was a little bit annoying. And finally, you can now also set a shortcut to switch between curve and keyframe views. And it's all of these little updates combined that, you know, it really makes a difference. I made a video, a tutorial, not too long ago on how you can do smart reframe in the free version of DaVinci Resolve, because smart reframe is only available in the studio version. And some of you told me that it was better than smart reframe because the method I showed you allows you to choose if you want to pan only or tilt only, which gives you a much more natural result. Well, they've now added that option to Smart Reframe. You can now choose to pan or tilt only. So if you use Smart Reframe a lot, try the pan only option because it looks a lot more natural. And then they've also added custom guides and snapping in the timeline viewer. So up here, just enable custom guides and rulers, and then you can drag your own guides from those rulers. And when you add text, for example, and move it around, it will snap when you come close to a guide. Now, that's great because I love snapping, but I also hate snapping sometimes. Sometimes I love it, sometimes I hate it. You know what I mean? And that's why one of my most used shortcuts on the timeline is N, because I use it to enable and disable snapping of clips. But I can't seem to find a way to turn it off in the timeline viewer. I don't know if it's possible, but if it is, let me know, because sometimes I hate snapping. Magic Mask V2 is absolutely great because it saves me so much time. Now, it's not perfect, of course, but if you know how, and maybe more importantly, also when to use it, it's great. And you can now also use Magic Mask V2 in the Fusion page. Now, most of the time I used it in the Color page, but I know that a lot of you were waiting for Magic Mask V2 to come to the Fusion page. Well, here it is. And this is another small improvement, but you know, it makes life when editing just a little bit easier. You can now also switch the timeline resolution on the fly in the color viewer. You can find the button up here. Okay, now before I show you my absolute favorite update, let's talk about another favorite of mine, Audiio, the sponsor of this video. Look, I love adding music to all my videos because, you know, it adds an extra layer of creativity. But that doesn't mean that I always have time to look for the perfect song. Well, no problem with Audiio because tools like Hans AI and Linkmatch AI will help you to find the perfect song literally in seconds. Hans AI allows you to find the song by typing a simple text prompt, and in Linkmatch AI, you just have to copy-paste a link to a video with music or your favorite song on Spotify, and it will find similar songs in an instant. And if you use my link and code in the description, you get 70% off your first year. So that's just 59 bucks for an Audiio Pro subscription. Go check it out, and of course, thank you so much, Audiio, for supporting my channel. Okay, and now back to the DaVinci Resolve 20.1 updates. Okay, this is my absolute favorite. Just this update alone makes 20.1 worth it for me. So before, when you used images on your timeline and for some reason you needed to add something or change something to the image in Photoshop or Affinity. So let me just add, I don't know, a yellow line here. Well, before, after you saved the image, it didn't update automatically in Resolve. You had to restart it because even relinking the clip didn't work. Or you had to rename the image and then import it again. Anyway, frustrating, that's what it was. But no more, because now as soon as you save the image in Affinity or Photoshop, you will see it getting updated instantly in DaVinci Resolve. Wow. They also made a lot of improvements to effects and added some new effects even. ColorTone Diffuser, for example, which emulates a flasher filter is what it's called, I think. Now, what is a flasher filter? Well, it's basically a glass plate that's lit from the sides and you can change the color of the light and it affects contrast and shadow detail. It's basically like a low contrast filter, I guess. Used mainly when shooting film, but now it's also an effect in Resolve with different presets and lots of controls to get your desired look. Now, it's not something I'll use every day, but it's definitely fun to play around with. There was already a split tone effect within the film look creator, which they've improved with natural and strong modes, but they've now also added a dedicated split tone effect. If you like teal and orange and film stock emulations, definitely try it out because it allows you to add different colors to highlights and shadows. So also here you have the strong and natural setting, and then you can adjust the strength and hue. Hue is what decides which colors are being added to highlights and shadows, and they're always opposite colors. So if it's blue in the shadows, for example, it will be yellow in the highlights. Now, if you want more control, then use the custom setting here, because then you can choose the colors separately for the highlights and the shadows. So split tone, it's a very, useful effect actually. And they've also improved the light rays effect, and it's really cool. So they've added atmosphere and shimmer controls to the light rays effect. Now, from what I understand and from what I saw when playing around with it, shimmer makes the light rays move. Well, yeah, like shimmer. Look, when I use it on a still image, see, it's like the leaves of the trees are moving, or they're making the light move. So it looks like the light is, shimmering through. So it basically affects the light source, and then atmosphere adds noise or particles to the air. So it looks like there's dust moving around in the air where the light rays are. See? And both of these settings just add more realism to the effect. And then finally, there's phase grain. Now, what's phase grain? Well, look, let's say you had a rough night. Way too many beers, not enough sleep, and you have to record a video in the morning. What do you use then? Exactly, face refinement. See how refined I look? So face refinement you can use to just smoothen out all the roughness in your face. But the problem is that if you use the face refinement effect to smoothen skin, for example, it will also smoothen any noise that's present or grain. And it will make it look very obvious that you did some skin smoothening, because it just doesn't look right. Now, before this update, you had to make a mask of the face and the skin and then add noise to only those areas and then match the noise to the unsmoothened parts. Difficult, but not anymore, because now you can add noise to the smoothened parts of the skin and face in the face refinement effect. So that will make it a lot easier. And there's a lot more updates and improvements. I'll put a link to the full list in the description. But yeah, these are my favorite ones. And look, improvements and updates are always nice, right? But when you can feel that a lot of the updates and improvements were done because the users, you and me, asked for it, well, that makes it even better, right? And I can feel it here. So thank you so much, Blackmagic Design, and thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.